Okay, we talked a lot about soft power and bringing Taiwan to the world, and I've noticed as an American who's lived here for 12 years that, you know, when I go back, there are non-Palestinians who care about Palestine, there are non-Tibetans who care about Tibet, but it's almost impossible to find non-Taiwanese who care about Taiwan who have not lived here. And you've mentioned bringing, like, connections through art and music, but it kind of feels like it's failed, and that Taiwan, the soft power Taiwan is trying to bring to the world is not working. And it's really frustrating because, like, as it, you mentioned in the film, that we're on the forefront of the battle between authoritarianism and freedom. Like, what happens to Taiwan now is what's going to happen to the world later when China finally stands up and starts making demands. So what are your thoughts on why, you know, the rest of the world doesn't care about Taiwan, what we can do about that? Related to that, there are a lot of foreign residents here who would like to be citizens. And we are a major source of soft power in this country, who we go back to our home countries, we talk about Taiwan, we educate our friends, we change people's minds. And yet the immigration laws, although they have changed, have not, they just haven't changed enough. And we're still, there are members of your film crew who want to be citizens and can't. And I'm wondering, like, what can we do about this? And I think those two questions are related, and I'm going on a long time, so I'll stop now, but thank you.
后面这个比较容易回答，就是关于移民法的部分，刚才我就直接连他问题都讲，但他的意思就是说，这个其实有很多在台湾想要在这边定居的到公民权的，但是台湾的这个移民法其实是很落后的。那这个我必须老实讲，在立法院里面，的这一种辩论哦，其实还是有很保守的一个辩论，包括很看不起外国人。 有一些人他甚至于觉得这个好像只有看不起东南亚人、白人就还好，其实不是这样的。你如果看我们的这个规范啊，老实说，要来台湾变成在融入这个社会，其实他已经融入了，但是要拿到任何的权利都是很困难。所以这个辩论的过，那而且政府现在都还很保守，所以他所有想来的他都会认为你是要来贩毒，哦，还是要来。 反正就是一定不是正常，要不然干嘛来？我们国家那么烂，你要来干嘛？我不知道他是不是这样想啊。要不，但是我任何一个，例如说我在帮这个宗教性的来，他就说这是宗教敛财。我说这个东南亚的，他就说这个是要来卖春。哦，我说就那要找白人的，他就说这是要来骗人教英文，其实哦是什么？就是很多啦。你只要跟着，所以我觉得要怎么办？我们当然是很希望。 在立法院里面，我们可以继续努力。然后，另外一方面，我也认为台湾在一直，我觉得台湾在往一个比往我们想象还要快的速度进步。哎，这我不知道怎么讲哦。例如说，LGBTQ rights 这件事，我觉得5年前没有人会觉得说我们现在居然有大法官可以说那是不能结婚是违宪的。所以，我觉得台湾的年轻人这一代，我是很有信心。 我刚刚讲的那个保守那一代控制整个官僚的机制，它终究是会被年轻人慢慢淘汰，所以我是比较乐观。那这也是我们在立法院，包括我为什么要组新的政党的原因。我觉得年轻人很重要。他前面那个问题是什么？就是哦，就 soft power 是不是失败的这件事啊？对我觉得我倒不这样看。这个第一个是面对中国有没有看到中国的本质。 这个最近全世界我认为都慢慢有感觉，你看到不管澳洲啦、印度啦，然后很多重要的国家开始重新思考哦，检举他的这个孔子学院，关他们的孔子学院等等。所以先不管台湾的话，中国跟每个国家之间的关系是不是很多国家开始有一些新的想法？我觉得有。那至于台湾的部分，我也不认为是失败的。 我觉得这几年，你如果看台湾跟几个欧洲国家，还有日本，还有美国，为什么他们愿意站出来帮我们讲话？不是，我是不相信外交部讲的说哦，因为跟我们都是同享 democracy 啦，都是 human rights 什么？我们自己到底有多人权、支持人权？这我都要打一个问号。然后，更何况世界上已经是民主国家的有多少？你如果这个讲得通，你就可以跟100多个国家建交啊。我跟外交部要来一个报告说，你觉得我们跟每个国家的前景是什么？就是未来发展潜力。他每个第一句都是说对方是民主国家，然后所以什么什么？我说这不是废话吗？现在还剩几个集权国家，所以这个根本是屁话。 真正的是我们跟日本人会好，我们跟美国会好，乃至于我们现在跟澳洲这两年的那一个民间的加强的交流变得很好的原因，都不是因为对方是民主国家，他们也认我们是民主国家，不是这种。我说的，我认同的是，不管是学术上面、文化上面，包括尤其是做生意，当生意人开始觉得他今天需要，不管做音乐的生意、电影的生意，还是一般的这个产业啊的其他的产业，我觉得这种连结是最重要的。这种连结，我在我看到的数字跟趋势，台湾人只有越来越国际化而已。
And we're almost out of time.
Yeah, I know.
我们时间就是快到了。So please bear with us. I would just like to say we have one more screening of the film on May 26th. So, and there's still tickets. So please tell all your friends to go buy tickets. Marco will be back for Q&A. So 就是五月二十六号还有一场。所以，然后就是还有票，所以如果你请大家是推荐给你们的朋友。
Well, I just want to say,
go ahead.
Thanks a lot because I didn't have the chance yet to my wonderful team. So you see, they're still filming here, yeah, right? So a lot of people involved in the film are here today. So we're going to the reception from the German Institute, and maybe you can talk to them if you like. I can introduce all of them to you if you like, and I hopefully on Saturday.Some of you are coming again, so I can introduce you. We can talk also about the teamwork, right?
Okay, 谢谢。
对，所以他要感谢他的组织，今天来了很多组织，然后就是等一下有过去红楼，就是有一个小的 after party.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. 好，所以我们就先。感谢我们要先合照。
好
Freddy, come here.
好。没有这边往这边。
哦。